Meet Singapore's pathogen hunters. What is a pathogen? Pathogens are viruses, bacteria, fungi, and parasites that cause diseases. Hui Tong, Alwin, and Nicole work tirelessly to monitor different animal populations for potential animal diseases that could affect humans. These pathogen hunters do this because human health comes hand in hand with caring for animal and environmental health.
Okay, we are here in Pulau Ubin today to conduct operations for bird winging and biosurveillance. Yesterday, we have set up 11 nets of varying sizes, ranging from 9 to 12 to 18 meters long. And today, we will open the nets and keep them open for about half a day. And we hope that the birds in Pulau Ubin will fly into these nets. We will be checking the nets every 30 minutes to see whether any birds have flown into them. So if we find any birds, we will take these birds and we will conduct bird winging. So this involves identifying their species and recording their features. We will also put a ring around their leg so that they can be identified if they are recaptured in the future. We will collect a swab sample from these birds to be tested for avian influenza. And we will also collect a blood sample from these birds for genetic testing.
So now I'm about to take a blood sample from this bird. So because it's a smaller bird, I like to pump the wing a little to get blood flowing because smaller birds don't tend to give a lot of blood. After I take the blood, then we release the bird and it's all good.
At the laboratory, we will register the samples and they will be processed to extract genetic material that will undergo a real-time PCR test for avian influenza virus, and the results will be out in up to 5 hours later. The samples that we collect today is part of our annual biosurveillance program, so we want to know whether avian influenza virus is present in the wild birds in Singapore, and if it is present, we know that so that we can take the necessary measures to safeguard public health.
It's 3 a.m. and we are at Tuas Checkpoint to conduct inspections of incoming poultry from Malaysia. It's so early because the cooler temperatures are better for the chickens and ducks, and we want to avoid exposing them to heat stress. When the truck arrives, we will use this torchlight to check they are still alive. We will also check for signs like discharge from the nostrils and discoloration of the wattles and combs. This is because these can be symptoms of bird flu, which is highly contagious and dangerous because it can be transferred from chickens to humans. The second part of the check will be to ensure that the import documents are in order. We check that the chickens and ducks are coming in from Singapore Food Agency accredited farms. After we do our checks, the trucks will be released to go to the slaughterhouse. When there is a case of high mortality, we will take a swab of the poultry and run the sample through a rapid testing machine. This equipment can help us test for avian influenza.
In Singapore, we have 182 different species of mosquito, some of which are known to be able to transmit diseases such as dengue and malaria. So the monitoring of this mosquito is highly important for us to understand where they are, what types of species is found in certain locations, and how many there are. This will help us in our mitigation measures. The night catcher targets mosquitoes which are night biting and which can be placed in a variety of environments. So this is a night catcher. We have used a variety of lights over here to attract the mosquitoes. We also have carbon dioxide in the form of dry ice, which is released through this tube into the contraption. So you can think of it as a carbon dioxide mimics the breathing of a host. Then the mosquito or other biting insects will then be attracted to the device. So a cool thing about this device is we have a rotating module which will rotate the collection tubes over time. This allows us to monitor like the period activity of the mosquito throughout the night. It seems like it's quite a successful catch today. We want to bring them back as soon as possible to the lab to preserve their DNA so that we can do the identification accurately back in the lab. So back in the lab, we process the samples that we catch in the field. We will freeze them overnight to kill off any alive mosquitoes. Then under the microscope, we will identify them using keys and references. Once we identify the mosquito, those that are intact, we will then keep them in the NEA repository. We will then use it for subsequent DNA molecular work For example, we can confirm the species identity or we can do pathogen detection.
What I like most about my job is I get to take care of the health of all animals, regardless of species in Singapore.
I am a professional insect identifier. A successful day for me will be that my findings in the lab will be able to be passed on to our operation colleagues who will then be able to mitigate any public health risk.
What I love about the job is being on the ground with my team and knowing that what I do has a direct and meaningful impact on Singapore's animal health and welfare. At the end of the day, I always go home feeling accomplished and ready for a nap.